Hey guys, it's Cal from the Lighting Doctor here. So many of you guys have been asking about how to wire your low voltage landscape lighting, and specifically how to show me a wiring diagram so we can show you how to do that. So that's exactly what we've done here. Forgive me, my drawing is not the best. I'm not a professional artist, but I do know how to wire low voltage landscape lighting. So I'm gonna walk you through this diagram. Hopefully it gives you a clear understanding, and after this video, I'll show you physically how we go and do that as well. But I think the wiring diagram will really help a lot of you guys out who are really, really visual people. So as always, if you have any questions, email me, cal@lightingdoctor.ca.
I wanted to give you a little more context when you're wiring the lights, because I always get this question is how to wire the lights. And at the end of this, I'll show you the video where I kind of walk you through it, but some people just need a diagram. So that's why we did this video. So I'm gonna show you how to wire your lights and what it should look like. So first off, when I talk about the 12-2 cable, it comes together like this and you split it at the fixtures. So if you look at my diagram here, when you have these two wires coming, it's actually just the one wire, but it's already kind of split in two. So how you go about wiring your lights now. So say you've got your lights that come from your transformer. As you split that 12-2, there's two taps or two ports in your transformer that each one of those ends goes into of that 12-2 cable. And then you run it out to your existing fixture. Now, what's gonna happen is one of those wires from the 12-2 is gonna go into your BVS2 snap lock connectors, and then there's another port where another one is gonna come out and go to that's gonna go out to the next fixture, wherever that might be, and then you have a smaller port in there that is gonna have your wire from your fixture going into it. So in essence, you're gonna have three wires going into each one of these. And at each light, you're going to have two of those because you've got one wire going in, you've got one wire going out, and then you have your fixture wire coming in. And then you have your other wire that's going to come into your other connector, and it's going to go out to your next fixture. And then you're also going to have your wire from your fixture going into your connector. So at every single light, you're going to have two of these connections, whether that be the last light or the first light. And I'll show you a close up of this in a second, but I just wanted to give you the general idea of that first. Another question I get asked all the time is what if I need to split into my 12-2 cable and run some wire out to another light that's off in the distance? Well, you can do that. The only thing is you're probably gonna use a different connection. We often use a DBRY connection. The reason being is that the BVS2 connectors, which I'll show you a little closer up, have two larger ports and one small port. So you're not gonna get three 12 gauge wires in that. So that's why we use these guys. Plus these are very, very solid waterproof connections. So how that looks now is you still have your 12-2 cable that's going out, and one of those wires is gonna go into your connector, and then at one of the wire, you're gonna have a wire that's gonna go out to wherever your next fixture is, and then you're also gonna tee in and you're gonna have that wire going to wherever you need it to. And then same thing, that other wire on that 12-2 strand is gonna come in, it's gonna go out, and it's gonna go out to your other fixture. So that's how you tee into a line, and I get asked all the time, and yes, absolutely, you can do that. The other question I get asked all the time is, what about the last fixture? How do I go and wire that with these connections? Well, you still have the same three ports, which again, I'll show you a close up in a sec here, but just to give you an idea, so wherever you're last fixture is, you're gonna have that 12-2 wire is still gonna keep coming out. And then of those two wires in that 12-2, one is gonna go into the BVS2 connector, and then the fixture wire is still gonna go into the smaller port on that BVS2 connector. And you're gonna do that with the other 12 portion of the 12-2 wire is gonna go into your connector, and then your fixture from your light is gonna go in. So in essence, the last fixture on the run is only gonna have two wires going into it, as opposed to these ones that actually have three wires, like we talked about, right? In, out, and fixture, in, out, and fixture. So you have three connections here, or three wires going into these connections, whereas on your last fixture, you only have two. And what that looks like a little closer up is like this. So if you can see here, we got three ports on our BVS2 connectors. Again, I like these because they're gel filled. These yellow things, they open up so that you can slide the wire in, and then they snap down on the wire to keep it nice and tight. But if you see here, we've got our 12-2 cable coming in. We're going to split that, and one of those 12-2s is going to go into there, and then it's going to also come out and go to our next fixture, and then we've got our wire from our fixture going into the smaller port. And then with the other part of the cable from the 12-2, it's going to go into the other connector. It's going to go out to the other fixtures, and then you're going to have the fixture wire is going to go into that smaller port. So just a close up of how that wiring connection should look. And then on your last fixture, it's going to look like this. You're going to have, so this is going to keep going, and you're going to have your 12-2 cable still coming to this last fixture. But here now, instead of the three connections, we only need, the three wires going in, we're only going to have two because it's our last light on that run. So the 12-2 cable goes into the connection, and then in the smaller port, we got our fixture wire, right? And then same thing, that wire gets split. It goes into the port on the BVS2 connector, and then you have your fixture wire, and that's the end. So on any fixtures that are in line, you're going to have three connections because you got to go in, out, and your fixture wire. And on the last fixture of the line, it's going to go in and basically just have your fixture wire, and you're going to have two of those at every light, no matter if it's your last fixture or if it's a fixture that's in line. And then lastly, I'll just show you a close-up of what it looks like when you tee into a line. So say you've got a light here, you've got a light here, you've left some extra slack because you've watched all our videos, and we say always leave extra slack here so that you can tee in or add on down the road if you have to. Well, this is how this is going to look. So you've got your fixture and you've got your 12-2 cable coming, and you need to tee it in. So you've got it coming into your DBRY connector, and you've got it going out, and then you've got another wire that's going to go to wherever that tee is that you want that wire to run. And then the other half of that 12-2 wire, same thing. It's going to go into that connection. It's going to come out to your next fixture, and then you're going to have that extra wire that you just put in to tee. And again, the reason we use these is just it's a larger hole, and it allows us to get three of those 12-2 cables in there. So stay tuned after this. I'll show you how you actually wire this physically, not just the wiring gram, but so many of you guys have asked for the wiring diagram, so I wanted to show you it. I hope it helps. If you've got any questions, as always, shoot me an email, and I'm more than happy to help.
Our 12-2 low voltage cable running back to our transformer. We're going to hook up this light, but we've got more lights down the road. So this is how we're going to use this. So again, you've still got your two wires at every single fixture. So you're still going to need two connectors. What we're going to do now is we're going to cut into this 12-2 wire, and then we're going to strip the ends to our wire that's going out to the next light. So we're going to strip that. And then our 12-2 that we just cut that's coming in from the transformer, we're gonna strip that as well. And then that's gonna make up our connections for this light. So we still are using the same snap lock connectors, except now instead of the two wires we just talked about at the end of the line, we're gonna keep this line going. So we're gonna have three wires going into each one. So we've got our wire coming from the transformer, we've got our wire that's going out, and then we've got our wire to our fixtures. So how we're going to do that is same as we did before. We're going to take one of our 12-2 wires that's going out, and that's going to go into one of the ports. Then we've got our 12-2 wire coming in. That's going to go into one of the ports. And then we're going to take one of the wires from our lighting fixture, and we're going to throw that into the small port. We're going to snap that tight. We're going to wrap that up with some tape. And then we've got another connection, so same thing, we're gonna repeat. We've got our wire that goes out to the next fixture, is gonna go in one of the large ports. We've got our wire that's coming from our transformer, that's gonna go into one of the large ports, because we've gotta keep that line going, so that's how we keep that line going. And then we take our last fixture wire, and we throw that in the small port, snap those tight, tape those shut, and we've got two connections at each light, but we've got the wire coming in, hooked up to the light, and then we've got it connected so that the line keeps going, and we're gonna continue to do that until we get to the end again, and then we're gonna finish that line.
I get asked all the time about wiring, and I'll show you, in a lot of the videos I talk about these are BVS2 snap lock connectors, because they're super easy to use. There's a couple different ports on them, but I'll explain two scenarios here. So one, here we are, I've got my wire going to the transformer, and then this is the last light on our line. So I'm not gonna have to keep this wire going anywhere, so I'm only gonna have two wires that have to go into this connection. So I'm gonna have the two wires that come from the fixture, and then I've got my two wires coming in from my 12-2 cable. So you can still use these connections. All you have to do is there's just less ports. So there's three on here. You're actually only gonna use two for each wire. So I've got my 12-2, and then I've got my fixture wire. I'm gonna tighten that up,
throw that in there and clamp it down nice and tight. Now that should hold pretty good, but I always wrap the base in a little bit of electrical tape too, just for an added measure. It's not to keep out the water or anything. I really want to make sure those wires don't pull apart, because I hate having to come and repair connections. So I do that just as an added safety measure. And then, because obviously you have two wires on the fixture, you're going to have two connections at every single light. So this is an example of how you're going to wire it if you're the last light on the line.